Welcome to Knowledge Plaza. Click on subscribe button, click on bell icon and select all and thumbs up for more videos.
Namaste, once again welcome to Knowledge Plaza YouTube channel. It's all about mathematics. So today I am before you to discuss about the topic of mathematics, which is on the quadratic equation, which is method of completing the square to find the roots for the given quadratic equations. Okay, so let us discuss about the topic by having some examples. Okay, let us discuss about the example. Find the roots of the quadratic equation 3x square minus 5x plus 2 is equal to 0 by the method of completing the square. CS means completing the square. Okay, let us discuss about the example that we have taken here. Consider the given quadratic equation 3x square minus 5x plus 2 is equal to 0. Okay, firstly, to make sure that the coefficient of x square is 1. If the coefficient of x square is not there 1, you must have to make it 1 by dividing the coefficient. What is there in the coefficient of x square? If there is any number for the coefficient of x square, you have to divide the whole equation by that number. Okay, let us see. The quotient of x square is 3. Okay, let us divide the given whole equation by 3. We will have, if we divide the given whole equation by 3, we are getting x square only in the first term, in the second term minus 5 by 3x plus 2 by 3 is equal to 0. Okay. And look at here, the coefficient of x, that is 5 by 3. Coefficient of x is 5 by 3. Okay. Multiply half to the 5 by 3. Don't consider the sign, whatever it may be. If there is minus or it is there minus or plus. Okay. You just have to consider only the term which is there. Okay. Into of, multiply it to the of. What will you get in? If it is can be simplified, you can simplify. If not possible to simplify, keep it as it is by multiplying the terms. Numerator to the numerator and denominator to the denominator. You're getting 5 by 6. Okay. Then after, to add this term, then to add this term on both sides of the given expression which we have get in the previous step. Okay. Look at here. By squaring that, we have to add it to the both sides, LHS and RHS. Okay. X square minus 5 by 3x plus 5 by 6 whole square plus 2 by 3 is equal to 5 by 6 whole square. Okay. Now we'll have x square minus 5 by 3x plus 5 by 6 whole square is equal to 5 by 6 whole square minus 2 by 3. The 2 by 3 is transferred to the right side. And then observe the left hand side. What we have here? So these three terms are in the form of a plus b whole square or a minus b whole square. If there is the middle term as we having a negative sign, then it is a minus b whole square form. If there it is, all the three terms are in the positive, so it is a plus b whole square form. Okay, so apply here a minus b whole square. A means x and b is 5 by 6, a minus x minus 5 by 6 whole square is equal to here 5 by 6 whole square means 25 by 36 minus 2 by 3. Okay, now simplify here, 25 by 36 minus 2 by 3. What is the LCM? What will be the LCM? LCM is 36, right? So your 25 as it is minus 12 is 24, right? So 25 minus 24 is 1 by 36. That means x minus 5 by 6 whole square is equal to 1 by 36. Okay, and next, what we have to do? Transpose that square to the right side. We are getting it. X minus 5 by 6 is equal to root 1 by 36. If the square shifted to the right or left, it becomes square root. Okay, so now it becomes a plus or minus, because square root has two signs, which is plus or minus. Okay, x minus 5 by 6 is equal to square root of 1 by 36 means plus or minus 1 by 6. Right, then transpose this find minus 5 by 6 to the right side, we are getting x is equal to 5 by 6 plus or minus 1 by 6. Okay, firstly we have to consider the positive value and then negative value, because two values are there for here, 1 by 6 or x is equal to 5 by 6 minus 1 by 6. Then you will getting x is equal to 5 by 6 plus 1 by 6 means 6 by 6, because both are the like fractions. So we can add the numerators. So 5 plus 1 is 6. 6 by 6 is 1. Okay, it is the one of the root, and next root will be x. Yeah, the like fractions already there. So 5 minus 1 is 4. 4 by 6. 4 by 6 means 2 by 3. Is the another root for the given quadratic equations by the method of completing the square. Okay, this is the method which is excluded for this year and which will be there for higher classes. Okay, and let us discuss about the next example. Okay, let us discuss about the next example, that is find the roots of the quadratic equation x square plus 4x plus 5 is equal to 0 by the method of completing the square. Okay, let us consider the first equation, x square plus 4x plus 5 is equal to 0. So here the coefficient of x square is already there, 1, so no need to divide it by any terms. Okay, so keep as it is, and you have to directly multiply the half to the coefficient of x. Coefficient of x is 4 into 1 by 2. We'll get in 2 1s are 2 2s are, that means 2. By squaring this, we have to add on both sides of the equation. So x square plus 4x plus 2 square is equal to 5 plus 2 square. So here 5 transfers to the right side, it becomes a minus 5. Minus 5 plus 2 whole square. Then what we have, x square plus 4x plus 2 square, that means it is of the form a plus b whole square form, because all the three terms are having the positive sign, and here's that it is in the form of a plus b whole square. So x plus 2 whole square is equal to minus 5 plus 4. So it becomes x plus 2 whole square is equal to minus 5 plus 4 means minus 1. X plus 2 is equal to the square get transposed to the left side, right side, it becomes plus or minus square root minus 1. So root minus 1 value is not valid for the is not considered to find the roots of the quadratic equation, so it has no real roots. It has no real roots. So roots are here imaginary. So for that, about that, we are going to study in higher classes how they are imaginary and how we have to find the imaginary roots for the given quadratic equations. Okay, so it is enough that the roots are not real. Okay, next. Okay, next we are going to discuss about the next example. That is, find the roots for the quadratic equation 2x square minus 2 root 2x plus 1 is equal to 0 by the method of completing the square. Okay, let us discuss here. 2x square minus 2 root 2 x plus 1 is equal to 0. Okay, so the coefficient of x square is 2 here. So let us divide the given equation by 2. Divide equation by 2, we're getting x square, and 2 here get cancels, we're getting root 2x plus 1 by 2 is equal to 0. Okay, now what is the coefficient of x here? Rho, that is root 2. That multiplied by 1 by 2. So we're getting root 2 by root 2 into root 2. Because 2 can be written as root 2 into root 2. So root 2 get cancels, we're getting 1 by root 2. Okay. By squaring this term, we are going to add the on both sides of the given equation. Then we're getting it x square minus root 2 into x plus 1 by root 2 whole square is equal to 1 by root 2 whole square minus 1 by 2. Okay, this 1 by 2 comes to the right side, we're getting minus 1 by 2. And next, x square minus root 2x, here x square minus root 2x plus 1 by root 2 whole square. Now it is of the form a minus b whole square identity. So apply here, x minus 1 by root 2 whole square, x minus 1 by root 2 whole square, this is equal to, or we're getting 1 by root 2 whole square is equal to 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2. 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 is equal to 0. X minus 1 by root 2 whole square is equal to 0. Then we're getting x minus 1 by root 2 is equal to 0. Okay, x minus 1 by root 2 is equal to 0. Then x is equal to 1 by root 2 is the root for the given quadratic equation. So as like this, we are going to find the roots for the given quadratic equation by the method of completing the square. Okay, this is one of the important method that we are to using for the for finding the roots for the given quadratic equations. If suppose the syllabus is taken again back, the excluded syllabus may be included for this year. Okay, so keep practicing the syllabus what we have. Okay, thank you. Keep watching the channel and subscribe the channel for getting more videos. Okay, thank you.